Eating more protein is associated with having less muscle, at least in this study of the older twins. Let's review the data first and then discuss the results and the common sense approach we can implement in our lives. Protein was and is the biggest interest of mine when it comes to food and longevity, because I think I have carbs figured out. Just maximize fiber and eat to your personal carb tolerance. Fats are more or less easy as well. Check your PPR and APOE4 gene makeup, or just see how your blood lipids respond to saturated fat and try to minimize APOB, that cholesterol-carrying vehicle. But proteins? There is no agreement between specialists. RDA goes for 0.8 grams per kilogram. Peter Attia goes for 2 grams from his clinical perspective, which is far more than RDA.
And the reality of it is, I think the RDA is predicated on how much protein you need to, like, live versus how much protein you need to thrive. And so I think when you look at those data, you realize it's probably closer to 2 grams per kilogram, or about a gram per pound of body weight.
Valter Longo, who is director of the Longevity Institute at the University of Southern California, based on his studies, goes for 0.7, which is slightly under RDA.
There is nothing wrong with having proteins and, of course, building muscle, but the amount that you need to get there is much lower than what people think. Don't forget, though, acute versus 110 healthy, right? Two different worlds.
Blue zones and my personal anecdotal experience, my grandma is 106, also point towards minimizing protein. And this study points at the same direction of keeping the lid on how much protein you eat. So, in short, they have looked at the roughly 3,000 twins over the age of 60 and found that there was no significant association between protein intake and low muscle strength. Basically, eat whatever you want, it doesn't affect the strength, but high protein intake was associated with low muscle mass, and low protein intake was protective. They provide no good explanation to this finding, other than high protein can be detrimental to the gut biodiversity. But my guess, it's mostly due to a healthy user bias. People who eat less protein are usually the same people who eat less meat because they think it's healthier to live on vegetables. So they might be adapting other healthier behaviors, which is hard to control for. And also, we have this higher quality study looking at the whey protein supplementation, and they have found that extra protein actually protects the muscle mass. But if we add evolutionary angle to all of this, it's hard to imagine that great apes and early humans had an abundance of protein in their life. So, as I said, the subject of protein is very interesting. And my common sense approach to this dilemma is, number one, worry less about protein, worry more about exercising. Because it's the strength and not the muscle mass which mostly affects the quality of life and protects you from injuries. Number two, hunt for your meat. Having more protein right after the resistance training might be the Goldilocks we all are looking for. And finally, one thing where data, evolution and longevity experts all agree on: keep your carb load under your muscle ability to utilize it. Which might be easier said than done, especially in our times of abundance and advertisement. But we have a tool which is amazing help if you want to keep your metabolic health and weight under control. Check this video out to find out more. It changed my diet and life completely. Living is smart, aging is bad. See you there.